Invite Dr. Shalini for her topic on a tonometer, how to use and use, how to choose and use best in different settings.
Thank you, Dr. Jyoti, respected chair and delegates in this hall. At the outset, I would thank Dr. Madhu for this opportunity to talk about tonometers. Well, we know that treatment of glaucoma is primarily based on reduction of intraocular pressure, and with variety of tonometers available, we need to choose which one is actually relevant for our patients. The question which comes to our mind is, how can we choose a more reasonable method according to the patient's situation? Which measurement method is more significantly affected by central corneal thickness? Are the results really interchangeable, and what about the inter-device agreement in different IOP group? Well, we all agree and we all know that Goldmann applanation tonometer is the gold standard for all our patients. The advantage being its validity, reliability, reproducibility and repeatability. But then we do have disadvantages like usage of topical anesthesia and contact modality. The amount of fluorescein may vary. We need experienced technician, sitting position and requirement of slit lamp and so on and so forth. And definitely it is affected by central corneal thickness. Well, let's see a particular situation where we have a hospital set up with busy clinic with PSC or CSC, or we are having a camp where we need to screen all our patients. In that scenario, applanation might not be possibility in each and every patient, and the answer to this situation is a non-contact tonometer. Well, this is a non-contact device which doesn't require any topical anesthesia, no requirement of any fluorescein dye. More importantly, it is a very quick modality and can be performed by paramedics. But then there are certain things we need to be cautious about. We need to take at least average of 3 reading. We need to confirm the findings with our Goldmann applanation tonometer at the extremes of IOP. It is more influenced by central corneal thickness than Goldmann applanation tonometer, and we cannot start treatment on the basis of NCT readings. And then it is unreliable in these certain situations. Therefore, for screening, it is definitely a good device, but for treating our patient, it is definitely not. Now, let's see another special situation like this, where we have a corneal opacity, corneoretic scar, or a post-refractive surgery patient, or a patient with bandage contact lens. Now, in this scenario, Goldmann applanation tonometer gives error due to certain things like pooling of fluorescein dye, because of thickening and thinning of cornea, irregular astigmatism, and then there are other factors also leading to non-reliable readings by Goldmann applanation tonometer. So in this scenario, we have learned and we know that we need a Mackie-Mark type of tonometer, and the prototype of which is Tonopen, which is available in the market. So it is a handheld device, and this area of contact is extremely small and therefore gives reliable measurement in the irregular corneas and also on therapeutic bandage contact lenses. And it has got good correlation with Goldmann applanation tonometer also. But it is not that it is without pitfalls, and as compared to Goldmann, it underestimates the IOP at lower GAT reading and overestimates at higher GAT values. And then it is also definitely affected by CCT. So we need to interpret our readings with caution. Now let's see another scenario where we have pediatric patients and cooperative individuals or patients who are lying supine in position. Now here we need a tonometer which is a non-contact device, which has a light disposable probe and makes a fleeting contact and springs back from the cornea. It is comfortable to use and it can be used in all the posture. Now here the answer is the rebound tonometer, where anesthetic drug is not required. It is more reliable than NCT and has got good agreement with Goldmann applanation tonometer. But then pitfalls are there. It is affected by CCT, and it is the requirement of disposable probes, which is a bit costly also to be used in every patient. Well, then what about this, our old age-tested device, Schiotz tonometer? Is there any role of Schiotz tonometer? So advantage is that it is definitely a user-friendly device, can be used easily by resident, optometrist, etc. Portable and very affordable. Anybody can buy it, even a beginner who can easily buy this thing. But then pitfalls of Schiotz are very well known. It is affected by scleral rigidity, by compressibility, Mohs's effect, and etc. and etc. But then Schiotz indentation tonometer has been found to agree better with Perkins and applanation than NCT. So if nothing is available, especially in periphery, then this device can be used as a screening procedure, although we need to be careful about interpretation of our results. Now coming to newer tonometers which are available, like dynamic contour tonometer, ocular response analyzer, and Scheimpflug analyzer Corvus ST. Now these all tonometers, they have advantage that it is said that they are less affected by corneal biomechanical properties. Until now we are worried about this factor only. So DCT, which is the slit lamp mounted device and designed to measure the intraocular pressure independent of corneal rigidity, is based on the principle of contour matching. So here we have a concave probe which matches the corneal curvature. So here what is happening, that the a constant force of 1 gram is applied, and the piezoelectric sensor measures the IOP 100 times per second. So the advantage is that it is repeatable and reproducible. The intraocular pressure measured is reported slightly higher than GAD, but definitely it is useful in keratoplasty and refractive surgery. But then pitfall is that, again, it is a contact device. Patient cooperation is very, very important, and we need a good and trained staff to actually use this device, and it is slightly more time consuming also. Well, ORA, which measures the bidirectional applanation values, and then the difference between the two is given as corneal hysteresis, and that is actually the measure of viscoelastic dampening of cornea. Low corneal hysteresis is associated with progression of glaucoma, but the good thing about this tonometer is that it is independent of corneal biomechanical property. Now coming to the Corvus ST, which is the novel device, it is actually a non-contact device where an air jet that indents the corneal surface at ultra high speed, and the deformation is monitored by Scheimpflug technology. So the advantage is it has got good repeatability and reproducibility. Because of non-contact nature, there is no risk of transmission of infection, and it has got good agreeability with Goldmann applanation tonometer. But disadvantage is the cost, which is pretty high, and then it is a newer device, and therefore we don't have much data and widespread use of this technology. So regarding interchangeability of tonometer, although all the tonometers available, they can measure the values, but the important thing is that they have got good agreement also, but we cannot use them interchangeably, where one tonometer in place of other. So measurement obtained by different tonometers cannot be compared, and same method should be chosen in follow-up also for our patients. Regarding corneal parameters, Dr. Sunita already emphasized that majority tonometry is dependent on CCT, except the newer ones. We need to record the findings. We don't have any fixed nomogram for central corneal thickness, but we can record in our patient whether the cornea is thicker or thinner, and then we can make a big box at the top that this is a thin cornea patient, so that we are more careful in that particular patient. So to summarize, I would say that Goldmann applanation tonometer is the gold standard device. And non-contact devices like NCT, ORA, Corvus, they have reduced risk of infections. Portable devices that do not require anesthesia, like Rebound, and these tonometers, they are actually helpful in screening of the patients, in pediatric patients, and they are quick also. The devices which allow to be used in supine position, like Tonopen and Perkins, are helpful in patients which are pediatric patients and cannot sit upright. The newer tonometers, they are definitely promising devices which are coming up, but they, as of now, they have not replaced the gold standard, which is the GAD tonometer. Thank you so much for your kind attention.
Thank you, Dr. Shalini. That was an excellent presentation on tonometers. May I invite Dr.